two, one, boom.
Sweet.
Yes,
what up?
What up, people? We're live. We're enjoying. We're enjoying our own podcast. Let's see. There we are.
There we are.
Yeah. Now my head's not getting cut off. You guys can see
sweet.
Top of my hat now.
What's happening? What up, everybody? We're live.
Happy Monday.
Episode 17 already.
Welcome back to the podcast. Episode 17 of Mondays with Mike and Marty. And we have a really big announcement.
Yeah, we did.
Tonight.
We have a huge announcement. Okay, that's an appropriate time to crack this. This is only my third one today. It's alarming. Aunt Laura's watching. What's up, Aunt Laura?
What's up, Aunt Laura?
What's up, Ashley? Alright, got some people coming on. Brittany. Hi, Brittany. Once you guys are on, hit that like button, hit the love button, share it. Once you share it, it'll bring everybody else on.
Yep.
And then we can get started because we have a really cool announcement today and a really cool topic today. I'm going to share it to a bunch of people.
I'm going to share it to a bunch of groups. Share.
Even if they don't care about health and nutrition, I'm going to share it anyway.
Share.
Once you guys are on, say what's up.
Hey guys, how's it going? Thanks for tuning in once again tonight.
Big announcement, big topic.
Big, big announcement, guys. Something that me and Mike are extremely excited about.
Yeah, very
so,
excited about.
Should go to my Twitter feed.
Hey, Nadine. Cool.
How are things with you? How was your Monday?
It was good. Today's my Friday.
Today's your Friday.
Yeah. Sick. Tomorrow's my day off, so today's the end of my week.
Very nice, very nice. That's exciting.
Yeah.
Got any good plans for tomorrow?
Training in the morning.
Okay.
What else am I doing tomorrow? I actually have some shit to do tomorrow. Training in the morning. I am going to hopefully see my family, my aunts and uncles and cousins.
Sick.
That'll be cool, yeah. So that'll be fun. My aunt just had a baby last night.
Congratulations.
And so we're gonna go see her hopefully. See what's up. See the little keto baby.
Little keto baby.
We'll put ketones in her bottle. Ooh, that was so we'll do that. I think that's it.
Cheers, buddy.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers, cheers, cheers.
Thanks, Nadine.
Thanks, Nadine.
Yes, Aunt Laura, I will be there tomorrow. Luckily, tomorrow's my day off, so
yeah.
Perfect timing. Good
that's
thing
nice.
She had the baby last night so for my day off.
Perfect timing.
I'm sure she meant to do that.
Very convenient.
Yeah.
It was very nice of her to
right?
Wait. So, you know, Mike's off on Tuesday.
I might as well just do it Monday.
Yeah, do it Monday. We're good. That's awesome.
I've never actually seen a baby that small.
No?
No. So I'm kind of excited.
Okay.
So that'll be cool. Yeah. Definitely cool.
It's an exciting time.
Yeah.
It's a very exciting time.
Yeah. Yeah. That's going to be really cool.
We did some strawberry picking this weekend.
Nice.
Yeah.
Where did you do that?
Out in Riverhead, we went out to this farm called Golden Earthworm.
Okay.
Where we get our vegetables from every week.
Right on.
And it was dope.
It sounds
like,
fun.
Picked out like three huge pints of strawberries.
That's right. You know what? I want to do that. I want to do that this summer. Because everyone's always like, well, let's go apple picking. And I'm like, I'm allergic to apples. So I'm allergic to every fruit with a pit.
Really?
Allergist's words.
Interesting.
I literally looked at her and I was like,
really?
What?
Interesting.
That's a thing? Every fruit with a pit, it's been accurate so far.
Okay.
I've learned it the hard way from a couple of them.
But do you get like anaphylactic or something?
Luckily, no.
Okay.
My whole mouth, my tongue, my lips, my throat all swell up and get itchy.
Damn.
So it's not something to mess with, but luckily I don't have to stab myself with the pen.
That's good.
But everything's been so far, plums, peaches, cherries, literally, you name it, I can't have it if I don't pit. But that works out anyway, because really berries are the only keto fruit to begin with.
Very true.
But every time someone's like, let's go apple pick for the fall, I'm like, okay, I'm going to pick the apple, but like, what do I do with it after that?
I'm just going
to
throw them.
I'll just pick the apple and give it to you. Strawberry picking. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Yeah.
I don't see why it wouldn't be.
Yeah. It's fun.
That's something to do. I'm going to add that to my summer list, I think.
Yeah, it was a good time.
Yeah, I'm going to add that to my summer list.
I would say try to get out there earlier.
Yeah.
I don't know how much longer they're in season.
Okay.
So,
all right, so I'll have to make that a summer thing to do soon.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
That was a good time.
I love strawberries. So
strawberries
are probably fucking insane, too.
Straight up, just nice picked right off the
Yeah, that's what I need.
It was a good time. The only downfall is that it's like, there's like crazy tick season going on. So when we got there, there was a lady, like her husband was like picking a tick out of her. I'm like sick, and I'm like just about to go to the field to go get like strawberries.
Yeah.
I'm like, so after I saw that, I couldn't stop itching for the rest of the day.
Yeah, I'd be like, wait.
Well,
Sorry.
It continues. So I went to my niece's stepping up graduation, so she's in kindergarten, and we were in the backyard. A couple weeks ago, my niece had her for birthday, and my wife said that she found some ticks on her my younger niece.
Okay.
So when we're sitting outside for dinner, I found something crawling on my leg, and lo and behold, it was a fucking tick, and I swiped it off my leg. And then I was like, and then I continued to get even itchier because I'm like,
yeah.
I didn't want to stand down.
I saw it, yeah.
And then later on that night, my Kelly saw a little tick on my sister's sweater. I'm like, I hadn't seen a tick ever in my life.
Yeah.
I've seen three.
Wow.
In bed. So
that's fucked up.
Guys, be careful with
be
the ticks.
Be careful with ticks.
It's
shit.
They're no joke this year.
All right. Well, that's good to know.
Yeah. Just in case you guys are hiking or whatever, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's a tick that if you get bit, apparently you become allergic to red meat. Yeah, that's like a true.
I have heard that before. That's interesting.
You would be allergic to red meat and fruits with pits.
And tree nuts. And dairy.
What the fuck can you eat?
What the fuck?
There goes keto.
I was talking to a customer today, and I was down, and she was like. Getting down on herself, she's like, oh, like, I'm picky, and I'm like, you have no idea. I was like, I'm picky, and I'm allergic to it, and I named all the things, and she felt a lot better about herself after that. She literally looked at me, and she's like, oh, you're all kinds of fucked, aren't you? And I was like, yeah, pretty much.
It's like, thanks for putting
it. Really good way to put it.
Yes, I am. Yeah, the Lone Star tick, that's it. Maybe you're allergic to meat.
The Lone Star tick.
It's crazy.
Fuck that thing.
Yeah, right?
Ugh.
That would be so sad.
I would be really sad.
Imagine not like being able to eat a steak.
No.
Again, or like a hamburger.
We had some guy come in today, preached that. Oh my god, this was so funny. We were literally laughing at him. He comes in. He's a company representative.
Okay.
Sales guy, I guess.
Yeah.
He comes in and he's like, oh, he tries to sell. He sells produce.
Okay. Cool.
Locally grown produce.
Cool.
Comes in with the sheet, what he offers, prices, and we're like, is it organic, non-GMO, are there pesticides used?
Yeah.
And he goes, no, it's not organic or non-GMO. He's like, I've never heard of anyone dying from pesticides.
What?
And we were like, what the fuck are you talking about?
What?
Like, he literally straight up was like, there's nothing wrong with non-organic and pesticide infested fruits and produce. And he was like, well, a vegetarian is the best way to go. That's the healthiest. And we were just like,
just please leave.
Instead of ripping you apart right now and embarrassing you, just please.
Just please leave.
Please stop.
Please
stop while you're ahead. Well, yeah, Nadine is vegetarian too, but she does it the right way too.
Right.
You know,
You made the choice.
She doesn't try to preach fucking, like, this guy was coming in, like, that's like the guy who interrupted me when I was with the customer to tell me that CBD is bullshit. Literally, even I blew it off because I don't get mad. The customer was like, what? Like, the customer was almost like, who the fuck are you?
Yeah, really.
He went, I'm in the pharmaceutical industry. CBD is bullshit. I wanted to be like, bro, CBD is not a pharmaceutical. But, okay, I just let him have it because I think he wanted to, like, you could tell he like kind of just wanted to sound
like. He
wanted
to get on his high horse.
So I was like, I just let him have it. I was like,
so,
okay.
You know what? Take your win, but it's your loss.
Let's see.
So we got a couple people on.
Yeah. Some people are on. Let's get a Like and Love River going.
Yeah.
To hype us up before this announcement.
Yeah, we're excited for it.
Like and Love, share it out, big announcement.
I don't know, do we wait a little bit?
Should we dangle it?
Should we go into the topic a little bit?
Hey, Robin. Should we dangle? Yeah, you know what? Let's wait a little bit. Yeah. Let's make the wait. Hey, Natalie.
We're gonna jump into our topic a little bit.
Well, stay tuned.
Because
stay tuned on this live.
You guys just gotta continue watching the episode.
Yeah, continue watching, and we're gonna announce it like in a little bit.
We're playing the long game for you guys. All
right. Hey, Eileen, Leanne, cool. All right.
Awesome, guys.
Dope. So, fitness.
Fitness.
Good topic.
Yeah, I thought so.
That was, yeah.
I thought so.
100%.
You know? Oh, thank you guys for the love.
Yes.
Look at that river. Love it.
There's a wow face too. I love it.
It's the wow face. Like, shit. Now I gotta wait and actually.
Hey, Melanie.
Watch the whole podcast. Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah,
get
hang out with us.
Deal with it.
What else are you doing on a Monday night?
Thanks, Ashley.
Huh? The Mets suck. Alright? No one's watching the Met game. And if you are, you're torturing yourself.
You're torturing yourself.
I'm a tortured Met fan, all right? They're already losing 1-0. It's typical.
Typical.
But anyway, fitness.
Fitness.
I know a lot of people think about fitness.
Yeah.
They get afraid of fitness.
A lot of people get, fitness is intimidating.
It is.
It's intimidating. I can understand why people get intimidated by fitness.
But it's that extra 5% that you like to throw in where you do the 95-5. Or for everyone else that does the 80-20 of 80% nutrition and 20% fitness. We never really touched on it.
Yeah.
The other side of the coin.
Still very important.
As they say.
Fitness is still very important.
And I think it's incredible important.
Yeah.
That's
how I started out. I started my entire lifestyle. I started out with fitness.
Yeah. You did training, right? You still do training.
Oh, yeah. I was a personal trainer since 11th grade in high school.
Sick.
Yeah.
That's dope. How'd you kind of get into, like, personal training, I guess?
I did this. I miss this class so much. I did it in high school. This is why I didn't go to college.
Okay.
So, in high school, I took 2 years of college courses.
Cool.
Didn't have to pay a dime for it, which was awesome.
Always solid.
Studied all college material. So, it was fitness. Fitness, nutrition, sports medicine, kinesiology, anatomy and physiology, and like personal training etiquette.
Cool.
How to actually carry yourself as a trainer,
okay.
How to sell yourself as a trainer, you know. So we did 2 years of that. The first 11th grade, it was 2 hours a day, 5 days a week.
Nice.
So I did 11th grade, it was mostly textbook work, anatomy and physiology, learning the human body, how it reacts, kinesiology, nutrition, sports medicine stuff, and then a lot of that. The second year, we had a full gym,
sick,
attached to the classroom, so it was next to the classroom. So the second year, we were in the gym doing hands-on work,
okay,
like really learning. Okay, here's how the proper form for all the exercises.
Yeah.
And the teacher was awesome. His name is Anthony Vidal. He's a strongman competitor.
Nice.
He's like my height, but he's fucking massive. Like, his forearms are like the size of our heads. Like, he's huge. He's like the nicest guy in the world. He actually is a doorman on the weekends at Rustin Gold in Huntington.
Okay.
I haven't seen him in a while. Like, after high school, we met up a couple times. We trained, you know. We got really close in high school. Obviously, like, he's my teacher. We really couldn't like, hang out then. But as I got older, I got more mature, became an adult. And then, you know, like, we were really close. I was like top of my class. Like, because I was so like, passionate about it. There was a competition actually in the gym. It was every, like, they had, like, auto mechanics, they had, like, nursing.
Okay.
So all of those things in the school had their own competition.
Cool.
And our competition was that we had to put one of our classmates through a shoulder workout.
Okay.
Pretending they were a client.
Yeah.
Do everything properly. You know, they were. We had to put them through a shoulder workout. There were three judges who were very successful career personal trainers judging us. So we had to put them through a shoulder workout, explain what those workouts were, why we were doing those instead of others, what muscle groups they were working, using proper form, proper etiquette, proper terminology, everything. And then at the end of it, the judges, you know, judged, and there were three winners. I won first place. First place, I still have the trophy in my room, so I'm super proud of it, and that is
an awesome accomplishment.
Yeah, there was a decent amount of people in the class competing, and the fact that I won first place made me really happy. That's kind of what started my, like...
You're like, fuck,
that's kind of what gave me... Yeah, like, that's what gave me the confidence to be like, alright, like...
I could do this.
I'm gonna... If I won first place, I was the best out of however many kids, like, I'm doing it. Like, I got first place on this, like, it's... That kind of kickstarted me into it. So that was really cool. That was a big accomplishment. That's why I, like, even after graduating in 2010.
Okay.
So it's been a while already, but I still keep that trophy everywhere I go. No matter if I move or for whatever, that trophy stays. So that's kind of what kickstarted me. That was a lot of fun. And then, I saw him. I haven't seen him in a while. I went to Rust and Gold for drinks, and he's standing there like, mean and like, because like, you're, you know, you're a doormat. You kind of have to look intimidating.
Yes.
So people don't try some shit, because the people in Huntington are like fucking stupid.
Yes.
Like, they're kids.
People act up.
So he's standing there just, he didn't recognize me at first, so I didn't have all my tattoos when I last saw him. And like, he's standing there looking on weed, and he sees me, and I recognize him, and we're like, oh shit. And like, he recognizes me, and he's like, oh my god. Like, it was really cool. He's a good dude.
That's awesome.
Yeah, he's a very good teacher. They canceled that program.
That's a bummer.
The year after I graduated, we were the last graduating class, and
that's a bummer.
They didn't feel it was a necessary program, and I was like, that's so sad.
That's bullshit.
He was one of the best teachers. He's still a teacher, just he teaches.
That's a lot to fucking education.
Yeah. So, I mean, that was cool. That's kind of what kick-started me into it, and then...
That's cool.
You know, I've been doing on and off martial arts since I was, I think, like 8 or 9.
Wow.
Yeah, like, my dad was always into it, my cousins were, you know, usually into it. I just, like, I went on and off with it for a while. I'm back at it now. I go 3 days a week to my school in Hicksville, so it's like, you know.
Karate or just
Muay Thai.
Muay Thai.
Yeah.
Okay.
I started with karate, and then I went to boxing. I did Krav Maga, and then Muay Thai is my number one favorite. Like, once I did like a week of that, I was like, all right, nothing beats this. Nothing.
You're sold.
So now it's like I go back. I go to East Coast MMA in Hicksville. Really cool people.
Cool.
And then. That's my thing now. 3 days a week, one time.
I
lift weights 2 days a week to keep them, to keep the frame.
I always want to try, like.
It's fun, man.
Brazilian jiu-jitsu.
They offer jiu-jitsu.
I think that's my.
Yeah.
The one that I took like a bunch of like intro classes over the years.
Yeah.
And it's just been.
Jiu-jitsu is cool. It's just.
Yeah. It's,
they offer it too.
It's fun, you know. Like it's something that I would really like to.
Yeah.
Like. Pursue at one point just to continue to be active. Eileen S said that she wants to start using free weights and she needs a routine. But we're going to get into that a little bit.
Yeah,
tonight.
We're going to get into
routine for beginners and whatnot. And I think outside of the Brazilian Jiu Jitsu thing, I've always been an athlete, really.
Yeah.
So, lifting wise, it's like I've always tried to go with like lighter weights, and I've played baseball my entire life, you know, and like basketball and baseball, and since I retired from baseball, I played golf a lot, but it's I trained, I think when I was playing sports, the science and like the information that's out there now on like how people should train for specific sports was not around or wasn't readily available as it is now compared to 10-15 years ago when I was playing like actual really baseball. Not that I was playing fake baseball, but a lot of the workout routines were kind of built around more of a like a weightlifting type deal. And for baseball, I mean, especially because I pitched.
Okay.
You know, lifting heavy weights was the, like, you're not supposed to lift heavy weights, you know, you're not supposed to do shoulder presses over your head. And,
yeah.
You know, it's bad for your shoulder. And granted, I mean, if you're training just for whatever, I mean, go ahead and throw 100 pounds over your head.
Yeah.
You know, go do it. But if you're a pitcher and you need your shoulder, throwing 100 pounds over your head, not always the best thing.
Yeah.
You know, because you have to stay limber and you have to stay loose and you can't be tight.
Yeah.
You know, if you get big, you can't throw a baseball off the mound.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that was my, you know, I've always just kind of followed routines that were given to me by coaches and maybe at the time the coaches weren't the smartest people, but you know, I've always loved like working out, but like I don't think I really actually got into actually fitness wise up until, you know, when I started, like I've always worked out, gone to the gym and did a routine, whatever, but I didn't really actually start getting into it until like a few years ago. Now it's like, you know, now I love going to the gym, and now that I don't play baseball, it's like, and there's so much more science and information out there of like what you want to, like what you can do to achieve to kind of still stay athletic, but not, you know, become a giant person.
Yeah.
But
especially there's so many supplements now that it's like people mess around with some crazy shit,
yeah,
and they think it's gonna like, they want to get, a lot of people want to get results so quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Every day someone asks me, or a kid comes in, oh, how can I get big? You know, like...
It's like, yeah, you know, put that $65 supplement that you're about to go down.
Yeah.
There's a gym down the block.
Yeah.
Start lifting weights.
Yeah. Like, you know? People just want the quick fix. Everyone comes in now, oh, I want a fat burner.
For everything.
I want a fat burner, I want... Like, I tell everybody, listen, we have fat burners. If you're eating like shit,
it's not gonna work.
Like, I'm sorry, it's just not. There's one fat burner. There's the fierce fat burner.
Okay.
You've met Nick before, right?
Yes.
Nick from Fierce came out with a fat burner. It's called Fierce Burn.
Okay.
And I don't know. And it's really cool, and it's all natural. And there's a cool ingredient in there called Cinnitrol.
Okay.
It sounds weird and sketchy.
Yeah.
It's actually, it comes from a citrus fruit, and there's like, they have like clinical human studies on it. Like, it's like pretty cool. I always tell everybody, I'm like, if I were gonna use a fat burner, that's the one I would use.
Okay.
And you know, people that come in trust, you know, what I,
of course.
Because if it's a crazy, like,
you guys are knowledgeable in what you talk about, so it's, you know
like,
not,
and then some people come in, they're like, I don't give a shit if it's natural, I don't care if it gives me a fucking heart attack, I wanna lose weight, and that's when I'm like, alright, here you go.
It's like, can you please just give me straight steroids?
Yeah.
You know,
a lot of people are just like, that's what, you know, the kids are too, you know, like kid. No, kids
well,
in their early 20s,
and
kids my age too. They're like, yo, I just want to get big, bro. And I'm like, all right, bro, but like, you're eating like shit and you're not working out properly. Like,
right.
No matter how many steroids you take, it's not going to work. It's going to work the wrong way.
Correct.
You know, it's going to harm you in some way. So I'm like, you know, I see so many, and also too, like, I'm so big on personal training. I loved personal training. Like, I wish I had time to do it still.
Yeah.
And I love, like, I think personal trainers are phenomenal. But it's just like, I stress to everybody, just be careful. Because, like, I can go online, I can take an open book test literally while we're on this podcast. And by the end of this podcast, I will be a certified personal trainer. So it's like a lot of fly-by-night stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the industry makes it too easy. And I hate to say it. I really hate to say it because I was a trainer first and foremost before I even knew shit about nutrition.
Right.
Like, I was a trainer while I was still like scarfing down PB&Js, thinking it was healthy. If you are working with a trainer, just be careful.
Be smart.
So, like, most trainers, I hate to say it, and most trainers don't know what they're talking about, and it sucks because you're paying them probably a decent chunk of change for no results. And I find a lot of trainers too, they try to give nutrition advice,
which is
almost dangerous. Like, a lot of people come in and they're like, yeah, my trainer told me to do this. And I want to be like, your trainer does not know nutrition. Like, that's...
He knows how to get you fit.
Yeah, like, so, like, just be careful with your trainers. I know a lot of great, amazing, one-of-a-kind trainers And I know a lot of trainers that are completely full of shit and might as well not even be trainers.
Right.
You know, that's like anything in any industry.
Well, I guess that was my big thing, because yes, a few years ago I was on the whole like CrossFit's stupid training.
I bashed CrossFit for a while until
I
tried it.
And I think it was always because every time I talked to somebody, they got hurt.
Yeah.
And I'm like, and every time I would watch like a video online or something of people doing stuff, I was like, this is like a beginner's class, and you have people throwing up like serious weight, and they're getting hurt.
Yeah.
And like every other time that I heard people doing it, like they're like, yeah, I got injured doing CrossFit. Yeah, I got injured. I hurt my knee doing CrossFit.
I got hurt doing CrossFit, but I try to explain to people it wasn't CrossFit that hurt
right.
me.
It's the form.
It was the fact that I was a fucking idiot, and I, as a newbie, still learning the forms,
right.
tried to go hard for an hour a day,
trying to push you a little bit further than you should.
Yeah.
And I think that kind of segues into a lot of, like, if you're beginning...
There should be some sort of fundamentals. That's with anything.
Yes.
Like, there's a beginner, like... There's a beginner kickboxing Muay Thai class. There's
right.
begin. Even when I switch gyms,
class for everything.
When I went to my East Coast MMA, I told them I had years of experience, which I do. I have a couple of years of experience.
Right.
But even still, which I respected this a lot from them.
Kim, you do not miss the announcement yet.
No, Kim, you didn't miss it yet. Even still, like even though I told them I have experience, they put me in a beginner's class first.
That's,
I respect.
That's solid.
Because they don't know. I could say,
right, you can walk
in
and like, bullshit.
I have plenty of experience.
Don't worry,
like,
I go to the gym 4 days a week and work on my own.
Like, people like...
I watch the UFC on Saturday night, so
yeah,
I'm good.
I have experience.
I know how to do
And I respected that from them. And then after my first intro class, they were like, okay, like, you can go into the advanced classes when you sign up, because you're Steve.
Right.
You know, but when I used to teach kickboxing, and I used to ask people, do you have any experience? You know how many times people would be like, yeah, I have experience. But they didn't know how to stand or hold their hands. Which is like, you know, there's nothing wrong with that, but like, don't say you have experience if you don't. That's how people get hurt.
If
you walk into a CrossFit,
be honest.
If you walk into a CrossFit and you tell them you have experience, and they don't give you a fundamentals class, I mean, that's on them. They should give you a fundamentals class anyway. You know, there was a...
Don't lie about it. Like, if you're starting out doing basically anything, and you're going to someone for professional advice, people that know what they're doing and what they're talking about, don't go in there and be like, yeah, I work out, I know proper form, and I know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Don't listen to what they're going to tell you and let them bring you through the steps of how to get to that next level. Because you're only going to hurt yourself, like seriously injure yourself, and you're going to waste their time because they could be training you, like, you know, teaching you the basics, but instead they're putting you through the workout of the day and you have no fucking idea what you're doing.
Yeah, let them do their jobs.
Like, I'll be fully, like, I worked out and whatnot, but if I walk into a CrossFit class now, I'd be like, I've never done a CrossFit class
yet.
Like, I lift and I kind of know, like, what proper form is, and I kind of know what this is, but I don't know jack shit about the moves that you guys are doing, you know, like, and I'm almost certain that the form that I do have can 100% be corrected to be better, because I'm sure I don't do shit properly.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's the other thing that you see in the gym all the time, is that, like, after years of, like, going and kind of just, like, researching and, like, knowing proper form of the exercises that you're doing, like, just going in there and actually, like, seeing people working out, and just, like, you kind of just shake your head. You're like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
It's like, what YouTube video did you watch and you saw them say, hey, you should do this exercise this way?
That's the thing. The fitness industry is so saturated now. Mm-hmm. It's like, Gambo, shout out to CrossFit Strong Island. They're actually a really, really good CrossFit box.
Okay, so where are they located?
They're in Merrick.
Okay.
Really cool people. Eileen, I would love to kickbox, but I'm old. That is probably the worst excuse I've ever heard in my life.
Oh, shit.
I used to run the kickboxing school in Oyster Bay in Long Island, and we had people that were 65 to 70 years old are running laps around people my age. So I'm gonna squash your excuse in a nice way.
Boom.
You should absolutely try kickboxing, Eileen, because you'd probably be phenomenal at it, and you'd probably love it because it kicks your ass. Like when I take a kickboxing class, sometimes I'll like, when I used to take kickboxing classes when I was working there, I would have one of the other instructors teach, and I would have, dude, it would kick my ass. As conditioned as I am, and as like whatever, every time I would leave there drenched.
I can imagine.
Wring my shirt out.
I can imagine.
So, Eileen, you should try it. Why not?
Try new things.
Try new things. You're not even old. I don't know what you consider old, but you're not old.
Well,
I used to love seeing people like 65 years old. They're like rock in the bag.
Why not?
Like, damn. 50? 50's young? What are you kidding me? 50's the new 30. What do you mean old?
You ain't old.
Old. You're young. Please.
Was that knocked up? You old? She pregnant? Can't let a bunch of old pregnant bitches
old pregnant bitches in there. I love that movie.
It's a great movie.
Yeah, Eileen, I can tell you right now that 50 is not old. When I say 50 is the new 30, I actually mean it. Especially if you're eating the right way and you're taking care of yourself.
Do it. Yeah. Do it.
50.
50.
F-E-G. Okay, cool. I almost read that one. So I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Everybody show Eileen some love for 50 not being old. Let's hit a like and love river, because 50 is young, and let's show her that we think 50 is young. Because I
make a brain, people.
100% believe that. When I'm 50, I'm going to be doing the same shit that I'm doing today. I'll probably be a little bit crazier, but physically, I will be doing the same shit that I'm doing today.
There we go. Make that river.
That's it. There we go.
Show that love.
Show that love. Nice.
Mm. I don't know why I did.
That's always a good way to end something off.
Mm.
So yeah, fitness. It doesn't matter what type of fitness you do, whether it's kickboxing, CrossFit, jujitsu, regular weightlifting, running, cycling, hiking, doesn't matter. Going out and walking the dogs.
Awesome.
Doesn't matter.
Awesome.
Moving is moving.
If you're worried about going into the gym, and this is true for, I'm gonna kind of say this, that for the women that are watching this, if you're afraid to go into the gym to go work out because you think you're gonna get big and muscular and like all like jacked up and you'll be all like, you know, you can't like walk around at all, that is the furthest from the truth, guys. Like, you're not gonna go into the gym and get jacked, okay? What you're gonna do, actually, is burn more fat, because there's tons of people that just go to the gym and just do cardio. Like, that's all they do, and it's like, and then they wonder, like, they hit a stall for, like, weight loss, and they're like, why is this not working? It's like, look, you need to mix in weightlifting also.
Yeah.
Okay? Even, look, start with 5 pounds. Everyone started
weights
somewhere.
Weights
are awesome.
Use cans of fucking soup.
Weights
doesn't matter. Weights
awesome.
Are weights. Added weight is added weight. And like Marty said, the cardio is good, but from experience, I'll be totally honest, and this is going to burst a lot of people's bubbles, cardio does not do a whole lot for weight loss. I have news for you. The best that it's going to do is strengthen your heart and cardiovascular system.
And if you train for a marathon, I mean, by all means, go fucking run.
Yeah.
Run.
But, like, regular cardio at the gym, like, on the treadmill, on the elliptical, like...
It's good to mix it in.
If you're doing, if you're focusing on just that, if you notice, the people that do only that every day, like, on the treadmill, with their book, and they look the same day after day, month after month, year after year. They look exactly the same because it's not doing anything for them. Yes, elevating your heart rate's great. Awesome. Yes, doing cardio is great. That's good for you. You're getting moving.
Right.
Not knocking it. But if you're doing just that, it's not going to make you drop the pounds. Everyone's like, oh, I have people every day come to me. I want to lose weight. I should probably up the cardio, right?
No.
And I'm like, no.
No.
You should stop eating shit and use some weights.
Start
weightlifting. Weightlifting jacks your heart rate up as well. If your heart rate is up, you're burning fat. So like Marty said, mix the two together. That's what I do. I use Muay Thai as my I mean, I love it for a lot of reasons, right. But that's my cardio. Never will you catch me on a treadmill or an elliptical, not even for a warm up.
Right.
Because I don't try to joke. I don't try to kid myself.
And guys, you're also like, look, gyms nowadays are not cheap. Mm-mm. Okay. Mm-mm. So if you're spending, let's say you're spending $40 a month for your gym.
It's pretty high.
And all you're doing is going to the gym, walking on the treadmill or using the elliptical. Quit your gym membership and go outside.
Yeah.
And walk and do that.
Yeah.
Because
the outside.
Because that's free outside. Yeah. Because if all you're going to do is go to the gym and just walk on the treadmill for an hour, go outside.
Yeah.
It's free. There's fresh air. You can do it. And it's probably better for you than walking on the treadmill for
an hour. Yeah, you're using you're walking on terrain.
Like, I'm not knocking. Like, if that's what you want to do and, like, you know, if, like, that's all you can do and you need somewhere to, like, start, then by all means, like, I don't want to make it seem like I'm not, like, saying don't go to the gym and quit the gym if that's all you're going to do. In a way, I'm saying it, but you kind of, if you guys are kind of following along, you get what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like, start using the other equipment. Like, ask Mike or myself for, like, a little...
We'll straight up make videos for you if you want. You want us to make instructional videos? We'll do it.
Absolutely.
You guys are our viewers and listeners. What's in demand, we'll do.
Yeah.
You want us to make instructional videos on teaching you guys how to use certain things? We're happy to do it. We're at the gym a couple times a week anyway. All we gotta do is take a video of us doing it. You know, and we can explain it to you over message. And there's options, there's resources. There's trainers at your gym, and you know.
Do you still go to Blink Fitness?
I have to cancel that.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Okay.
I just don't use it. I haven't been there in months.
That's fair. Well, I was gonna say, Mike and myself are both members of Blink Fitness.
Yeah.
Mike is he's gonna quit. It's because he's pretty.
Quitter. Exactly. I'm going to cancel the membership because I don't use it.
However, one day a week ago, has a great... First off, for gym-wise, I find that of all the gyms I've joined, Blink has been, like, the best, like...
Blink's a good gym.
Big gym person
Blink
to
is,
join.
Blink
because, one, they're, like, $25 a month. Mm-hmm. Okay? You can have access to all the Blink... And, by the way, I don't get paid for this shit. I have no affiliation whatsoever with Blink. Okay, just I know from experience from going to Blink Fitness every single day that they have great equipment. They have great, like, my Blink just started, like, incorporating a lot of cool shit. Like,
yeah.
They have, like, the air bike now, and, like, the CRG, and, like,
right.
I think their kettlebells go up to, like, 55 pounds.
Dope.
You know, they've been incorporating some really dope, like, functional fitness.
Okay.
And if you're a member of Blink Fitness, you're allowed one free guest every single day.
Yeah.
You can bring a guest every single day at any time. So
it's awesome.
If anybody wants to go to the gym and, like, you know, get, like, a free whatever workout and, like, kind of go through some motions, then by all means, you know.
Yeah.
What's up, babe? Love you. Thanks for the hearts. You know, yes, I'm saying I love you to my wife. You should join it. You're the best. I hope Riley's feeling better.
What's wrong?
They're not giving you a PNAS. She had, like, a little, like, stomach thing. Threw up this morning.
That sucks.
Had some, like, explosive diarrhea before, so
it's fucked up.
Sorry, babe. Sorry.
Hopefully she feels better.
Yes, Gamble. It must be the sail away.
What must be the sail away?
Gamble said Mike and Marty are fired up. Must be the sail away.
Oh, absolutely.
Absolutely, guys. But, you know...
I have FOMO.
You don't have your phone.
My phone's charging, if you guys are wondering. I have FOMO.
I probably miss a lot of stuff, because this is Mike's live video, so I probably miss a bunch of comments that show up.
Eat loads of butter.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah, eat loads
Fuck
of
yeah.
butter.
Who doesn't eat loads of butter? What are we at? We're at 40 minutes right now.
Actually, I do weights 2 days a week and one day cardio. I can only make it 3 days a week. But my question is that I want to add more cardio. Should you cardio before or after weights?
That's a great question.
I was doing weights first, but I'm worn out for cardio.
That's a really great question.
That's a very good question.
Because a lot of people don't, like, kind of... A lot of people will say, maybe I'll do cardio first. What is your thoughts?
So if you're going to do a warm-up before weights, that's fine. If you're going to do intense cardio, I would wait until after. Just because...
Say it again? I'm sorry.
So I would do a warm-up before. Okay. 5 to 10 minutes of low-intensity cardio.
Okay.
Just to get the blood pumping. Intense cardio should be after. Only because the weights are going to do a lot more for you, and you don't want to be burnt out for your weights.
For sure.
I'd rather, if I were to work with my clients, I would rather burn them out with the weights and have them a little bit dragging and tired for the cardio, because the weights are really going to do a lot more for you as far as reaching your actual goals, whether it's losing weight, toning
right.
up, building muscle. So I would do the just a little bit of warm up to get the blood pumping, muscles warm beforehand. Kill the weights, and then afterwards you can do some intense cardio if you feel it.
And by kill the weights, he doesn't mean like don't do the weights. He means fucking go hard.
Yeah, go hard.
Kick
like
your ass.
Take all your energy.
Yes.
And hit the weights really hard.
For me personally, for at least what I like to do is
yeah.
I do like a little warm up, do a little stretching, whatever. I kind of pick like the body parts I want to work out for that day. I'll go really heavy, but I don't take breaks either between any of my, like,
awesome.
The only time I take breaks really are when I'm switching exercises. I lost my train of thought.
Ashley, do yourself a favor and don't people watch, because I'll be honest, most people are doing things wrong, so.
I have one thing about people watching.
I love people watching.
So. For me personally, for my routine is I get into the gym, I do a little stretching, do a little, you know, a little light warm up.
Okay.
Then I'll just hit the weights for whatever I'm working on that day. I don't take any breaks in between my sets.
That's awesome.
I try to just keep going, you know. Then the only breaks I do take is when I'm changing exercises.
Okay.
And then we'll do the usual. So on my chest day, I usually do like chest and triceps, and I'll do like two sets. I'll do like a bench, and then I'll do whatever, like a pull down.
Okay.
And then I'll do another chest exercise, another tri exercise. But then I'll mix in. Then I'll go into like I'll do like 30 kettlebell swings. Then I'll do like a little jump rope. So like in between it, I'm mixing in some like high intensity work.
Okay.
As well.
That's awesome.
And then I'll go back to lifting again.
Okay.
And then. Like I'll do two more exercises for each.
That's good.
And then I'll go back into, and then I usually always finish my workout with either some type of, I always do kettlebells. Like every single day I'll do some sort of kettlebell swings, deadlifts, whatever, you know, just because it stretches me out really well. And then I'll either finish it off with like 10 minutes tops, either the air bike, ski RG, the rower, or they have like a like an air elliptical type thing.
Okay.
So, and I'll finish off with that, and then I'll kind of stretch for like 3 minutes. And so like I'm like not breaking at all, and I usually get my heart rate like really, really high. Like I think the last time it was like 170 when I hit it. So that's just for me. That's my
because
I like to get my it keeps my heart rate pumping throughout the entire workout. I'm getting in some cardio, and it works for me.
Sweet.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, if you're new to the gym and you're lifting weights, please rack your weights.
Yeah. That's
fucking
just
eight.
Proper etiquette.
Yes.
If it says, it's labeled. If it says 20-pound dumbbells, don't put the 35s there or the 10s there.
Come on. It's a pain in the ass. Because then I got to take it off and I put it back on.
And for the guys, rack your weights if you're going heavy. If you can pick it up off the rack, you can put it back onto the rack. And if you're too weak to pick it up and put it back on the rack, you shouldn't have picked it up in the first place. That avoids weights being everywhere, people tripping on shit, and the gym being messy.
I have one story about the gym. So this guy in my gym.
Mm-hmm. Oh God.
He does, I try to get like 50 minutes in and I'm done.
Okay.
Just cause I go at lunch and I have a limited period of time to work out.
Okay.
This guy, I'm there for 50 minutes. I see him do two things the entire 50 minutes on there.
Okay.
So one couple weeks ago, he was on the leg press machine. He laid down on the leg press machine, put all the weights on, I'd say he did 10 plates.
Okay.
Okay. Super, super skinny, super tall. Sat on his phone for like 5 minutes. Didn't do any, did about 3 reps.
Mentally prepping.
Did 3 reps, put the lock back on, sat on his phone for about 10 more minutes. And this is me, because I'm going around the gym, like, doing all my shit, and, like, I just notice it.
Yeah.
Because
he hasn't moved.
He hasn't moved at all, and I just see him on his phone, and he's just flicking through shit. Just flicking through shit on his phone. And I'm like, and then, like, he'll go do something else, and then he'll go back to the same machine, and, like, I'm 50 minutes. I'm like, bro, I was like, what the fuck did you do?
Yeah.
I'm like, did you do anything?
No.
I was like, I saw you do a rep. And you've been sitting on your phone for the last half hour.
Yeah.
Okay? So don't be on your phone for a half hour at the gym.
Yeah.
Right? You're there to work out. You get a workout in. If you're going to check the phone, the only time I have to check my phone is because I'm at work. So I check my emails, and sometimes I have to have two phones.
There's a sign at the Blink Fitness in Hicksville. It says reps, not text.
Yeah, that's what mine says.
That says that too?
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah. So.
I'm like, yep.
So that's also gym editing. Guys, like,
yeah, that's just, yeah.
Be courteous of the people around you. So,
sure.
Like, if you're spending, like, 45 minutes on one machine,
yeah,
and people want to work in, you know, like, other people have other shit to do, and have time crunch is awesome.
Yeah.
You know? So, that's just part of etiquette. So, let's see. We have questions. Kelly asks, tell us more about working out and fasting. Pros, cons, do or don't.
Good topic, good question. So I usually, most of the time, suggest working out fasted if you can.
Okay.
Like when I take my Muay Thai class during the week, I take it, I have no choice but to take it at night. So I really can't train fasted.
Okay.
Tuesday or tomorrow, I take my morning Muay Thai class. So that's really the only time.
Right.
Every other day, I have to take a 7 p.m. after work because of my hours changing. So I really can't work out fasted as often as I'd like. But if you can work out fasted in the morning, I suggest doing it. You're burning a lot more fat that way, and you're getting a lot more benefit as far as like mitochondrial health, cellular health, stuff like that when you're training fasted. It might take a minute to get used to, but I'm a big, big fan, huge advocate on fasted training. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's got a lot of pros. I really can't think of any cons besides maybe in the beginning you might get a little lightheaded. But if you use your electrolytes, I really don't see an issue.
Right.
So
aren't you staying hydrated?
Yeah, staying hydrated, eating right when you do, you know, during the times when you do eat. I don't see why there would be any cons, me personally. Everyone's body responds differently, of course, but in my experience for myself and the people that I've helped with it, I see a lot of pros and maybe only one or two cons. And then as far as do and don't, I think do. I don't say do, I always say try. Try for a week or two, and if you feel good, you know, after a couple of days, you should continue with it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's if you're working out. Like I said, I don't work out fasted anymore just simply because I can't. My times don't work out.
Right.
You know, I can't, you know, I can't train fasted at 7 p.m. because I've been eating. So.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Here we go. How'd you feel? I feel. Working out fasted, I'd say...
I get so much better at a workout.
I feel, yeah, I get a great, great workout when I work fasted. I've had no problems with it.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe like once or twice, but it's probably just because I'm tired
yeah.
or, you know.
Also,
but,
too, guys, remember, like, when you're eating food, your body spends a lot of energy breaking that food down, digesting it, properly placing it where it needs to place, properly storing it the way it needs to be stored. So your body's wasting a lot, not wasting, your body's spending a lot of energy to do that, so you have less energy to work out. So if you don't eat anything before you work out, you have all the energy in your body because your body's not spending it to break down the food.
Right.
So it goes towards actually, you know, you keep your energy levels high.
Yeah.
When you have a fasted workout, you actually are giving yourself more energy for that workout. When I started fasted training, I stopped having to use pre-workouts.
What's your favorite cardio? My favorite cardio is, I like to do, I think kettlebells are amazing cardio.
Jump rope's my favorite.
Jump rope is dope.
Jump rope's my favorite.
Kelly, I don't know if you know this, but I'm fucking sick at jump rope.
Sick, by the way.
Like, I'm really, really good at jump rope.
I remember when I was first learning to jump rope.
Oh, I felt like a dick.
I caught the front of my ankle, I guess the bottom of my shin, face planted.
Ooh.
And because my hands were holding the handles of the jump rope, I had nothing to break my fall. And I smacked my face on the mat. Luckily, I was on a soft mat.
Well, that's good.
It still hurt.
At least you got that going.
It was funny. Everyone else thought it was funny. I was like, well, shit.
I like that to sounds. Do, Fair enough. The rower. We have a rower down in the basement. It's awesome.
Yeah,
I think it's fantastic.
Assault bike?
The assault bike
fuck
sucks.
The assault bike.
Sucks, but awesome.
Yeah, it's sick.
I texted you a couple weeks ago.
Yeah,
I did.
That was my favorite text.
I think it was like 8 minutes of an interval. I think it was like 30 seconds sprint and then like a 10-second rest. I could not breathe when I got off of it. And I'm pretty sure I got back to work and I texted you. I was like, the assault bike fucking sucks.
Yeah.
But it's really, really good.
Yeah.
So,
What did you say? I remember you said the assault bike can go fucking suck. I remember opening it and like dying laughing like in the middle of the store. Like, what the fuck?
The assault bike can go fuck right
now. It can, because the assault bike
awesome.
Like ruined my day one time, but it's sick for endurance. If that doesn't build your cardio endurance, I don't know what will.
No, Mike, your favorite cardio is when you dance with your coffee. That's true.
Good point. I retract my previous answer to my favorite cardio. Kim brought up a good point. My second favorite cardio is jump rope. My first favorite cardio is dancing with my coffee. If you don't know what we're talking about, you can go on my Instagram and look, because it was a video I posted and I was in the store, Mission Nutrition, by myself. It was like 9 a.m. I just opened the doors.
It was a great video.
And I had already had like, I just opened the doors and I had already had like almost an entire sail away. That's my routine. When I come in, I pour myself a sail away, I put the music on, and we have this little Bluetooth like speaker that's loud as shit.
Yeah, it's loud.
That little like wooden thing.
Yeah.
And I blasted it. There was no one in the store. I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I had the beats on. And I was like, I blasted it. And I just started dancing with salad cans for no reason.
That's.
And I decided to videotape it.
That's a segue.
Yeah.
Guys.
I think so.
Guess what? It's announcement time.
Announcement time.
Who's ready? Who's ready?
Let's get a like and love
yeah,
ring
like
for the announcement. Let's get this excited. Let's get this hyped up.
Hype it up.
Like and love.
Come
like
on.
And love. Thanks, Eileen.
Let it run.
Like and love.
Real fast.
Tap it. Like and love. We have a huge announcement. It's going to benefit you guys as well. That's going to benefit you guys more, actually. Yep, there we go.
There it is.
That's what I'm talking about.
Bring up before we do this. Yeah, keep it going because I'm going to try. I'm going to find something up quick so we're accurate in our information.
That's what I'm talking about. Shop and then. Yeah, and then swipe to the left, or actually never mind,
cool. Guys, are you ready?
Are ya?
Are you ready?
Ready?
Me and Mike, the Mondays with Mike and Marty podcast, officially as a sponsor.
We are officially a sponsored podcast.
By
the
world. Sail Away Coffee!
Ding, ding, ding. Sail Away Coffee is the official sponsor of Mondays with Mike and Marty. That means, here's what this means for you.
Yeah!
Sail Away has unsweetened cold brew in a bottle, nitro cans, sweetened, unsweetened, and sea salt caramel, and coffee beans. Now, them being the official sponsor of this podcast, huge shout out to Sail Away, by the way, and
huge shout out, guys.
Very grateful, very appreciative, and thankful.
So stoked.
Yeah, so this is a really, really cool way. Episode 17, still very new in the podcast world, and officially sponsored by such a phenomenal company. So definitely shout out to Sail Away Coffee. It's sailawaycoffeeco.com if you want to go and shop, because you guys now get 10% off anything you order.
Woo!
All you have to do is use the promo code KETOMM for Mike Marty. KETOMM. and you officially get 10% off everything you order. Sail Away can ship the cans and the bottles in, we're looking at the map, just so you get it right. New York, Pennsylvania, Virginia, Delaware, Maryland, New Jersey, Connecticut, and I believe he also said DC.
And a little bit of, did you say Virginia?
Yeah.
All right.
So they can ship that stuff in all of those states. If you're out of that range, you can also buy the coffee beans because they can ship those wherever. You can buy a bunch of them and you can make your own cold brew or a hot brew. So that's really super exciting. We're both very excited about that. You guys should be excited about that too because Sail Away is amazing. And you guys now get 10% off your orders when you are shopping on sailawaycoffeeco.com. Just use that promo code KETOMM. So super excited for you guys to get some discounts and start drinking the same Sail Away coffee that Marty and I drink every podcast for the last 17 podcasts. So super exciting stuff. That's the official announcement, official sponsor of Mondays with Mike and Marty. So that's really cool.
Yeah, they, yes you did, babe. Well,
Colorado, Eileen, you can buy the coffee beans. Buy the coffee beans. And you can make your own. I have no doubt that Sail Away coffee will be big enough in the coming years that they'll probably be in stores near you.
Did they say now they'll do the bottles?
Yeah, bottles as well, but I think they only ship those in the same states just because they have to stay refrigerated.
That's true.
So, Eileen, you can definitely go on and buy the Sail Away beans.
Yeah, let's do I'm going to throw in the comments for you guys.
Yeah, so sailawaycoffeeco.com. You can buy the beans if you're out of the kind of like that little radius. And if you're in the radius, you can buy the Sail Away Nitro cans and bottles.
Use promo code.
Promo code.
Keto.
We got you guys a promo code and that nice little discount, which is really awesome.
You're 10% off.
We're putting it in the comments so you guys have it.
There we go.
Sweet.
Yeah, guys. We just found out last week.
Yeah.
So, it's kind of been something that we've been wanting to work on.
Yeah, we've been trying to find a nice official sponsor, and we wanted to make sure it was someone we truly believed in, someone that we really wanted backing us and behind us. And as our podcast grows, we want someone like Sail Away behind us growing with us as well.
Yeah.
So that was definitely good news to hear.
And what better way to kind of team up with a dope local company that is run by awesome people
and just a little cool little bit of information, the owner of Sail Away is full-blown keto. We converted him. So the owner of Sail Away actually follows a ketogenic diet for most of the time, and he actually looks really good. He's actually getting more like muscular, and he doesn't really work out. When he delivers kegs, he makes the picking up the kegs of workout. Because I asked him, I was like, bro, like, have you been working out? Like, I know you're doing keto and you look great, but like, your arms are getting like pretty like defined and everything. And he was like, no. He's like, I literally, every time I go and deliver kegs, I make it a workout. Like, I purposely like lift the kegs certain ways. And I was like, well, awesome. It's working. Those kegs are heavy as shit.
Yeah.
So like, I've carried a couple of them and they're not light. So you can definitely make it a cool workout. So, yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, Sail Away.
Thank you, Sail Away.
Yeah, we
very, very generous.
We're very appreciative for you joining up.
Yeah.
With Mondays with Mike and Marty. Kim originally in her comment said you're pregnant. I don't know if that was meant for me or Mike.
Which one of us is pregnant? Let me know. I need to know.
I may look pregnant.
I need to know to stop drinking so
much coffee.
I
haven't really been eating that great, so I may look pregnant.
You gotta let me know, Kim.
I felt pregnant yesterday. That's for sure.
Sometimes I can't drink that much coffee if it's me, so let me know. My baby will come out super caffeinated, both off. Oh, fuck.
We're coming up on an hour, so if you guys have any Q&A,
let's join in,
we dropped the big bombshell on you.
Let's end it off with some Q&A. We're at almost an hour.
We're both pregnant.
Oh, shit.
We're all pregnant.
I'm going to still drink coffee. The baby comes out the way the baby comes out.
That's fair. It's going to be highly caffeinated.
It's going to come out like,
woohoo, coffee.
All right, so let's get some Q&A going to end off this episode strong. You guys are always really good with Q&A. If you have any questions at all, simply let us know. This is what happens when we drink Sail Away coffee.
Yeah.
I don't know why you guys are surprised. But
for anyone that's tuning in the last 5 minutes, Mondays with Mike and Marty is now sponsored by Celebrate Coffee.
Super excited, super, super psyched about it, and it's going to be a lot of fun for the coming episodes with someone teamed up with us like Sailaway. It's a strong team. If you guys ever want to buy the Sailaway like we do, now you have a promo code. If you have questions about it, you can message either of us because Marty and I both know a shitload about Sailaway. So,
I think so.
I think we know. I think it's safe to say.
It's safe to say. Do you drink coffee before you work out or after?
Nadine, sorry, I know you asked this before, so I want to answer it before I forget again. I will be in Hicksville. I'm off tomorrow, but I'll be in Hicksville literally every other day this week besides tomorrow.
Womp womp.
Back to Kelly's question.
Do you drink coffee before or after you work out?
Well, I drink coffee before only because I've been working out at night.
Okay.
So I'm drinking my coffee in the morning and during the day, and then I'll go work out at night. But like tomorrow, I'm working out in the morning on my day off, so I'm going to take half a scoop of Nutribio's natural pre-workout to do my workout, and then I'll stop at Mission and get coffee for like later in the day.
Okay, that's fair. Would you do a, like say you're working, would you do a Bulletproof before you work out?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, with all those healthy fats in there, it'll carry you through your workout, it'll help you burn fat. Those, you know, the brain octane, the MCT oil, that all turns into ketones, so you'll have extra fuel. Opposed to like a black coffee, you'll have added fuel. It'll keep you kind of full through your workout, and it'll help burn fat. So yeah, but I'm a big advocate of Bulletproof, like an hour or so before your workout.
Also, we don't advocate doing. Never mind, I'm not gonna say.
What is that?
Never mind, I'm not gonna say.
Nah.
I'm not gonna say. Kelly kind of knows where I was gonna go with it, but I won't. The least favorite form of exercise. What is your
cardio? unless I'm at my MMA gym hitting things. And
who likes cardio?
I hate cardio so much.
Who likes cardio?
That's why I said before, you will never catch me on a treadmill or an elliptical. The most you'll ever see me on is the Stairmaster, and I probably don't usually do for more than 5 minutes because I get so fucking bored. And I just knowing that cardio is not doing any much for my physique,
right?
It's not necessary for me. I get my cardio when I train at my other place, and that's good for my heart health. And that's interval cardio because it's high intensity for 3 minutes, hitting the pads, and then we rest for 60 seconds,
right?
Or 30 seconds or whatever. And then it's high interval, and then we switch partners, and then I get a little bit of a break, and it's on and off intervals, which is a really good form of cardio.
Right.
And it's also not boring because it's not.
It's fun.
Yeah. Cardio. No.
Very true.
True. That's my least favorite form of exercise. And I also hate yoga.
What?
I can't sit
still. You don't like yoga?
I can't do it.
Ooh.
I can't do it. Maybe I tried a bad yoga studio and I have a bad taste in my mouth.
Okay.
I heard the yoga studio that I did try once is like one of those cult yoga studios. It's called Don Yoga.
Okay.
Apparently they have millions of them all over the place.
Speaking of cults.
It was stupid expensive, dude. It was like $500 for 3 months.
What?
This was when I was like 22. I still don't know where the fuck I even got that money from.
Fucking out of here.
And I did not like it at all.
$500 for 3 months?
I didn't like it. I hated it. I'm used to high intensity, punching the bag, punching the pads, working with a partner, getting punches and kicks thrown at me. Like, that's fun for me. Like, I like that. That is fun. But for me to like sit there and like, okay guys, let's stretch. And I'm not knocking yoga. I think yoga is very useful, very helpful. Like, I genuinely wish that I liked yoga because it's so helpful. There are so many benefits emotionally, physically, and mentally for yoga. Like, yoga treats so many cool things. So I genuinely wish I liked it, but I just can't get into it.
You know what?
Maybe I didn't give it a fair chance. I'll be open-minded about my answer, but I did try it and I did not like it.
I've never been to a yoga studio before. However, DDP Yoga, Diamond Dallas Page, the wrestler.
Okay.
Okay. Has his own yoga program.
Interesting.
Okay. It is really good.
It sounds cool.
It is really good.
Maybe I'll give it another shot.
So, the whole science behind DDP Yoga was that there was this one guy, he was kind of out of shape, he was a para jumper.
Okay.
In the military.
Yeah.
And I guess from all the jumps that he did, he got like damage in his legs, and all the doctors told me he'd never actually be able to like walk, and like, and the whole promo behind his original yoga tape was the guy started doing it, like started doing it, and then like later on down the road they showed videos of him progressing and like not falling over, and then you see him like sprinting down the path.
Yeah,
it's
awesome.
It was a lot of fun too, you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
I mean, imagine. Growing up as a DDP fan, like as a yoga wrestling fan, like it's like, you know, makes you get to do the diamond cutter and stuff.
Yeah.
It's just fun, you know. It's engaging too.
Yeah,
it's not so much like you're sitting in a studio. You're doing it at home, and you're not in a studio like you said. But I would like to go to a studio to actually.
It was listen. I enjoyed the fact that I did get to experience it.
Hot yoga.
Hot yoga sounds cool.
I would like to do hot yoga.
I
want
to do aerial yoga. Hang from the things.
Ah, that looks cool.
That would be interesting.
I don't think I could do that though.
That takes like real strength.
Yeah. I also want to try locomotion.
That's cool shit.
I want to try that.
That's cool
I was talking to Love and Supply earlier today.
That's cool
shit. I was
like,
I need to make my way over there.
Very unique. Useful in ways that we would never imagine.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really cool stuff.
Yeah. I would like to try that.
Nice.
What else we got? Right. Yoga has been awesome.
Are we? Shower in 6 minutes.
Shit.
Damn.
That's what happened.
We got
fired up and having a good episode.
All right. Well, that was exciting.
That was a lot of fun.
We'll be back next Monday.
Tuesday.
Tuesday,
we have a great guest.
We have an awesome guest coming on Tuesday. Super excited about that.
Do we tell
him? No, we'll make him wait.
Yeah. We have a guest next week.
We have a really cool guest next week.
Just know that.
Shares a lot of the same ideas. She has a lot of the same concepts as we do. We actually, as a team, Mission Nutrition converted him from full vegan to keto.
Damn!
And he's loving every minute of it.
He's really
and he looks awesome. So we're going to have him on. It's going to be a lot of fun. So stay tuned for that. Tuesday is going to be our podcast instead of Monday next week.
Yeah, sorry.
So
I got to work.
Keep that in mind. And that's that.
That's that.
Thank you guys for being awesome. Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you guys are sharing, liking, loving, rating us on iTunes, SoundCloud, Google Play, YouTube, reviewing us. So, means
five stars, guys.
Yeah.
5 stars on iTunes.
If you guys didn't keep this going, we wouldn't still be here, and we wouldn't be able to have awesome sponsors like SailAway. So, big shout out to you guys, and keep it going.
And don't forget, KetoMM.
KetoMM.com.
It's in the comments.
In the comments.
And we'll put it in the recap. On that note, you guys have a good night. See you next week.
See you guys later.